Aloha everybody, my name is Danny.
And I'm Erick, and today we're gonna give buyer tips.
Yes, so if you're looking to purchase a home, what are some things that you can do to make your buying experience a pleasant one?
I think we need this because I've been having like the same questions come up over and over with my buyers.
Yeah, so. What kind of questions do you get?
Okay, so number one, the one misconception there is that as a buyer's agent, the buyer thinks that they have to compensate you, they have to pay you something. But that's a lie. So we're actually doing the work for the buyer at no cost to that buyer. The seller is actually gonna pay both agents from the commission of the sale.
Yeah.
We don't get paid until it closes, right? Until the deal closes. And that money's coming from the seller.
Right. You have the person who's looking to buy a house, and then they have an agent that they work with. And you have the person who's selling the house, and they have an agent that they're working with, right? Mm-hmm. So that's why you have two agents.
And if you're on the buying side, 100% have an agent because it's nothing out of pocket for you. Plus, you get the expertise of an agent. They have the local knowledge. They know how to negotiate on the price and everything like that.
Yeah. You know, doing market comparison analysis, like all the homes that are within the area, schools that are nearby, some things, amenities and maintenance fees, you know, stuff like that.
And you don't have to pick the first one you see or the first one you meet because a lot of people do that as well. Interview them, ask them questions, you know, ask them what, you know, anything, what they've done, what area, what they recommend.
What's their expertise?
Exactly.
Yeah. Only the seller is paying both the seller's agent and the buyer's agent.
So yeah, you don't have to worry about the commission split at all because that's set by the selling side. Tip number two, have your pre-approval ready to go. And this is the thing that you get it from your loan officer. You don't know a loan officer, your agent will know him. That's another good reason to have an agent. Ask your agent and then he'll give you some referrals and you can go talk to different loan officers and see which one fits your needs the best. But the reason why you need that pre-approval letter, because we can't even put an offer in without it nowadays. You know, before you could put offers, but now they want that letter, at least a pre-qual. And what's the difference between a pre-qualification and a pre-approval?
Okay, so that's a great question. A pre-qualification letter is just a simple letter where the bank or the loan officer has talked to you and said, you know, oh, how much money do you earn a month, right? And it'll ask you some basic questions. That's just the simple, easy part, which everyone can get, basically. What you really want to get is a pre-approval letter by your loan officer. Now, that is where they go into your tax payments, your tax returns, any debts that you owe, child alimony, all that stuff.
Your credit score.
Getting a pre-approval letter is super important because it shows that you're a serious buyer and you're not wasting anyone's time.
The way the market is, especially at the lower price points, it's still going fast. I mean, Hawaii is still going fast. Now, the higher price points, so above 500,000, it's slowing down a little bit. But in the 500,000 range, I just got beat last week too, so.
you put in an offer, but then they already accepted a separate offer.
Yeah, it was like 2 days on market.
2 days on market, wow.
And we put asking price, someone came over asking. So, wow. I mean, at the lower price points, it's still going fast, but you need that pre-approval, because if you like it, you need to get it before someone else does. And tip number three.
When you're checking out websites like Zillow or Redfin, they're great resources just to get a basic information. And you know, you can go through and look through photos. Really great resource for that. However, they are missing a lot of detailed information, especially when you see things like, oh, mortgage, only $1,500 a month. That's not true. You're gonna have to talk to a loan officer to get the actual numbers.
What's happening recently with my client, they send me some Redfin or Zillow postings. It's already in escrow. Or it's been sold. They don't update it.
Yeah.
So that happens sometimes too. But it is good if the client is active.
Yes.
You know, we love that. Yes. Because even though they sent me something that's already in escrow or already sold, it helps me understand what they want.
Yeah, it gives us a better picture.
Yeah, that communication's important. So I love when my clients are active like that. When they're sending me like a bunch of stuff, and then I send it right back to them.
So again, use those websites for just, you know, great quick searches.
It's a resource.
And then send it to your real estate agent, and we'll do the digging and checking up the info and finding out what the property consists of.
We always also get the buyers having fear about their credit score. Don't worry so much about your credit score. That's something so simple that can be increased, you know, with less than a year. So if you are in that area that it's the credit score that's stopping you from buying, come to us. We'll take it from there, because there's very easy steps that you can follow to increase your credit score.
Yeah, Erick actually helped one of your clients improve their credit score by a huge margin.
Yeah, and I did it to my own credit score. So I mean, I've had a lot of practice in this, and it's really not too difficult. So if you have those questions, email us
at alohalifenow@alohalifenow.com.